Hello, and welcome to Skyrim Roleplay, Series 2. My name is Zemalf, and I'll be your gameplay commentator and roleplayer through this slow-paced Let's Play. Here we go. Let me first introduce you to Ulik Enakis, Dunmer, the main character I'll be playing in this playthrough. If you watch the little intro cinematic I crafted, you know that Ulik is a miner and that he got attacked by bandits. But he survived that attack, and this is where our adventure begins. Ulik was mining in Margarth for many months. He was making money for himself and his family. But he lost it all when he took a ride from a Gachit caravan driver and got attacked by bandits on the way from Margarth towards Whiterun. But Ulik was going to Helgen through Falkreath. He was about to jump away from the Garth just there in the crossroads, but the bandits got here first. Ulik needs to get away from this area. The bandits might still be here. They left their bear traps there. So, it doesn't really want to be here for too long. Looks like the bandits left one apple behind and one hat. Ulik's favorite hat, in fact. And I think Ulik will eat that apple right away. I am using the Realistic Needs and Diseases mod and Frostfall mod, so I need to be careful in the cold areas and many other mods as well. I'll be talking about them a bit as we go on when appropriate, but for the full list, check the link in the video description and check it out yourself. In this Let's Play, I'll be mixing in character roleplay, acting as Ulik, and normal commentary, the kind I'm doing now. I want to do both, because I want to immerse myself really deep into the character and kind of play the role. But I also want to role play, kind of explain and think about my choices as a player. Why I do something, or why Ulik would do something. And also to talk about things that Ulik doesn't know. Also, this Let's Play is not Dead is Dead, like my Series 1 was, which was over when Ingvar died. I want to play through the main quest, I want to play through the Dragonborn DLC, and with the mods I have, with the difficulty I have at the moment on Master, I will change that if it gets too hard. It would just be too difficult if I played with Dead is Dead. But if you have watched my if you have watched my Fallout 3 Let's Play, for example, you know that I still immerse myself into the world very much and play like it was Dead is Dead, so no worries there. Ulik is not a mage, but like most Dunmer, he knows the basic destruction spells. And right now he doesn't have anything to defend himself apart from the spells, so he will use them. Ulik knows how to use a sword, he knows how to use a bow. He's not a master swordsman by any means. But he can defend himself. And the same thing with the bow. He has been doing some hunting. He knows how to skin an animal. He knows how to get the pelt and get the meat. But he hasn't been doing that professionally. For most of his recent years, he's been mining. And on the side, doing some smith work, that's about it. As I mentioned, Ulik was making money for himself and his family. And as an example of things I want to talk about that Ulik doesn't know. He has a family. He has a wife called Lilia, and daughter and son called Sherelle and Ulpar. And they live in Helgen at the moment. And with the gold Ulik earned from the mining, he was heading back home. But now he has lost it all. Of course, you and I know about the things that will take place in Helgen, but poor Ulik has no idea. So life will hit him hard. The bandit attack was just the first step. As far as Ulik is concerned, he wants to get home, he wants to get to Helgen, but at the moment he doesn't have anything, so he definitely wants to... wants to make some coin, to get some gear. The road from Falkreath to Helgen is dangerous, and roads have become more and more dangerous with the civil war, so he needs to be very, very careful. Where did you come from? No idea. That looks like a Dunmer patrol. Ulik is not too fond of the Dunmer. He doesn't particularly hate them, but he doesn't like them. In fact, Ulik doesn't really like anyone. He's kind of a selfish fellow, in a Dunmer kind of way. He does care about his family, he loves his wife and kids. Ulik hasn't seen these creatures too often. I think they are from the immersive creatures mod. I, as a player, haven't seen them before. Ulik is selfish. He won't shy away from stealing and lying when, if the opportunity presents itself. He will lie and cheat if it gives him an advantage, profit, or saves his life. With that, one thing I want to do in this Let's Play, and the idea when I started creating this character, was that I want to play less of a goody-two-shoes character that both Ingvar in Series 1 and Albert in Fallout 3 Let's Play have been. Ulik is not evil, he's not mad. Some might say he's bad in some ways if he steals or lies or cheats, but he doesn't see it that way. Right, I will continue on that story later. One thing I want to do in this Let's Play is, of course, roleplay from the perspective of Ulik. He has been in Skyrim for a very long time. I didn't really think about how old Ulik is or how long he has been in Skyrim, but he has been in Skyrim for very long. And in some occasions, I want to use my player knowledge to my... for role-playing purposes and to kind of create the story. And one example is here. I think Ulik knows about the hunters in the area, and he also smells that something is cooking. So he will go out and check, and sure enough, there's a hunter's hut on the top of the hill. And I think Ulik is at the moment very hungry. He wants to go and check if the hunters would give him something to eat. Hello? Is there anyone here? Hello. Would you mind if I get some of your meat?
They say the college has been snooping around Sarthal. Mages in a burial crypt. No good can come of that.
You are probably right, but Do you mind if I take some of your meat there and cook it?
Aye.
As far as gaming mechanics go, I think Ulik needs to steal this. But I think the hunter would be give Ulik something to eat. Because the hunter is right there, Ulik won't steal this, her gold. Or actually, right now, I'll actually take that book as well. You know what? I think Ulik would steal all this. I'm not sure if he would actually do it exactly at this point when I did it. Maybe he would first eat, and then when the time is right, he would leave.
I heard the good.
Oh, wait, what? Oh, she has a friend. I think I can cook this without anything. Yes, I can. Perfect. And one thing. While Ulik enjoys his charred meat, the hunters tell Ulik a story. They tell Ulik about a man who they met nearby outside a cave, and that man had an interesting story, and they shared that story with Ulik.
Name's Valder. I hunt out of Falkreath. We tracked a bear to this den. Good coin for those pelts. We had the big sow cornered when they showed up. Three of them, out of nowhere. Spriggans. Niels went down before we even knew to run. Ari died just inside. I never even thought the things were real. But now what? I can't just walk away, not with my friends' bodies in there being torn apart by those beasts. Thank you, my friend. I'll wait here.
And the reason why I showed that right now was that I had to go and start that quest because it was giving me some trouble, so I kind of took it into the story that way. When I will go do that quest, or will I go do that quest, I don't know. But I had to do that just in case to keep the game stable. It was for some reason very badly glitched. Yeah, I think Ulik wants to get away from here after stealing the hunter's items. I think he's thinking that he won't be here anytime soon. Maybe they won't even notice. I think in reality, I think Ulik probably would have waited for them to go hunting and then steal it instead of doing it right in front of them. And actually, I think the road might be a bit dangerous here, and I don't want to die just because I don't have anything to protect myself with. So maybe another thing that the hunters talked about was that they saw a dark elf corpse here. They didn't want to get his items. Maybe they believe it's bad luck, but Ulik don't mind. And I think maybe the hunters told the story to Ulik that maybe Ulik knows this dark elf, or they asked if he knows. But luckily, he's not Ulik's friends. In case you are wondering why I'm getting so many ingredients on one go when I pick up the pick up the ingredients. That's because I'm using a harvest overhaul mod. If abused, that's gonna be a bit powerful. It does decrease the cost you get when you sell the items, but I like the fact that I'm getting more than one flower. It's a chance-based thing, but I like the fact that you get more ingredients, because I think that's realistic. And if I want to get some ingredients for poisons or potions, I don't need to do that much collecting. I can do it just a bit. Right now, Ulik is doing it because he knows that there is an alchemist in Falkreath, and he knows he needs some coin, so he's picking up some ingredients. Ingredients to sell to that alchemist. Ulik is not much into alchemy himself. He knows the basic plants, and he just hopes that he will get some coin from the alchemist. Ulik might go and chop some wood for the lady here. He's pretty sure the lady is a vampire. He has talked to her before, but Ulik doesn't mind. As long as she doesn't try to bite him. But one interesting kind of out-of-character comment. There is no wood axe on this mill. And as I kind of was planning a bit on this early journey, I really wanted to go and chop some wood there. But there's no axe. I could make an axe appear with console commands, but I think Ulik wants to get to safety. He wants to get to Falkreath, and on his way he will pick up some flowers. Right, but to continue on the character, as I talked about, Ulik knows how to use a sword. He can defend himself. And I also talked about that he doesn't really like anyone, including the Talmor or any of the other races, apart from Khajiit. Ulik, in his childhood and also in the recent years, has had many Khajiit friends. And especially in his youth, he was doing some stealing and lockpicking, so he definitely knows how to do that. And as far as how this... how this let's play will proceed, I will pursue kind of stealthy Nightblade thief kind of gameplay. And Ulik will be doing some thievery. I'm not 100% set on thieves' gear. Whoa. Okay. What the hell? Where did that skeleton come from? Well, at least I have some help. Way to go, Ulik!
Is someone there? Thought I heard something.
Did you? Is there more of them? Well, don't mind if I do. This might be dangerous. There is no necromancer, is here? Is there? I think Ulik is caught in the heat of the moment, following this guy. He forgot for a moment. That he wants to get to safety.
That's your best, huh? do that.
Sorry. Hey, thanks, Bell.
I'm on my way to Windhelm to join up with the Stormcloaks. Ulfric has the right of it.
Oh, I could kill you for that. Well, Ulik will get everything from this guy. And I think the skeleton came from here as well. That was a lucky break for Ulik, definitely. I wasn't planning on coming here. But thanks to that pretty badass farmer, that went well. And this will be very good for on getting some supplies for Ulik. Normally he might not loot everything, but right now he needs everything he can. Plus he might get a bit hungry as well. Let's just get absolutely everything. Huh. The Khajiit got burned into ashes. I think Ulik is feeling pretty good about himself right now, with the use of his destruction magic. I'm not sure if Ulik cares that much about books. But I do, and I'll be reading books during this Let's Play, but I'm putting them on a separate playlist. There is already... Come on. There we go. There is already a playlist, Books of Skyrim, where are all the books I read in my first playthrough, the series 1, and I'll be adding to that same playlist when I read books during this one. Right, that was very fortunate for Ulik. Maybe now that he calms down, he's thinking a bit what the heck he just did. attacked a necromancer. Without any proper protection, apart from a lousy steel dagger he found, but I think with the farmer aside him, he got the confidence to do it. I have no idea what I was talking about before that skeleton appeared. I think it was something about Thieves Guild and Ulik possibly doing some stealing and thieving. I haven't decided on the Thieves Guild, but I will see how it goes. The main quest and Dragonborn DLC on the main focus, and everything else I will see about as I go on. Ulik, you shouldn't even be thinking about it. But Ulik sees a dead bandit. Maybe he, in the adrenaline rush, of killing the necromancer, he wants to check out what they have here, but the hunters told Ulik about Spriggans, and I believe that's one of them. Okay, Ulik, go away. You are not prepared. Ooh, okay, Ulik. This is not the time for that. You crazy, crazy man. As we approach Falkreath and Ulik makes it here safely, despite his foolish bravery, I have talked a lot already about Ulik and his background. There's a lot more I have to talk about, and I have thought about already, but please post any feedback and questions in the video comments if you want to know something about Ulik. Of course, things will take quite a drastic change also for what kind of man Ulik is as we go on after the events ahead in Helgen. But anyway, what kind of man Ulik is, if you have any questions that I didn't talk about yet, feel free to post those thoughts and comments in the below the video. You are helping me to flesh out Ulik's character as I go on. And now that Ulik came here safely, he will take a little inventory on the stuff he collected. I think first thing he will do is go and sell those alchemy ingredients to the alchemist. Ulik has been in Falkreath before, traveling away from Helgen and back to Helgen. So he knows his way around. Maybe some people here in Falkreath even know his name. He doesn't know them that well. He's not the kind of man who goes and talks to strangers. He comes in, rests in, takes some ale and food and heads his way. But the locals have seen him, so he's not a total stranger to them, at least to some of them. But now, when Ulik is safely here in Falkreath, I will conclude the part one here soon. One thing before that, however, if you liked this video, if you enjoy my playstyle, if you want to keep on watching, please do me the honor and hit the like button on the video. And if you really loved this, share this video with your friends through Twitter and Facebook and other sites you might be using. I really appreciate that, and it will help me make more videos. And also, when you continue watching, do take advantage of the playlist. The link is in the video description, and there's also annotation up there to the part 2 with the playlist. Use that, put autoplay on, and enjoy the ride. And whenever you need to leave off, just bookmark, and you can continue from the playlist from that video later. If you are new to my channel, please check out the channel. There's links to the schedule, FAQ and things like that. And do subscribe if you enjoy my content. You will get notified about the new videos. But this is where the part 1 ends, where Ulik Enakis started his journey, arriving safely in Falkreath, and the story will continue into part 2.
I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow in the knee.
Well, Ulik took one to the face, and that was just the beginning of his adventure. And for this journey, as it continues, I really hope you will join me on it as it continues into part 2. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.